In part C, Feynman was just stopped and John was just holding him there like this. But John is starting to sweat some, his hands are becoming sweaty, and so the rope starts to slip through his hands, right? And Feynman starts to accelerate down the hill at 2 meters per second squared to his peril. And so John is exerting a force on the rope due to that friction in between his hands and the rope. And so let's find what that force is. That will be the tension force. So let's consider the free body diagram for this situation. So the force analysis is the same. I've drawn it here, right? The forces are all acting in the same locations. This T will, of course, be different. It will be T for part D. We'll label it like that. And the acceleration will be different, right? So this, the acceleration here, let's go ahead and put, this is BC, right? And this is acceleration in part A. We could do that. And because Feynman is accelerating down the hill, we see that that's in the negative x direction. So the acceleration as a vector will be equal to negative 2 x hat meters per second squared, like so, right? Let's see if I can draw this little... Okay, so the acceleration is down the plane now. So let's consider Newton's second law. Again, we're just considering the x components. So we'll start by saying the sum of the x components is equal to mass times the acceleration in the x direction. And so then this will be T sub d, positive T sub d, still, you know, he's still exerting a force upward, right? The rope's slipping through his hands, but he's still exerting a force this way, minus the weight of Feynman plus the sled times the sine of 30 degrees as before. And then that is equal to negative the mass of Feynman plus the sled times the acceleration in this x direction, which will be 2. And the negative, I've just factored the negative out in front, right, just to show that this whole term will be negative. Okay, so I'm going to substitute mg for this weight of Feynman plus the sled. So we have T sub d minus the mass of Feynman times mass of Feynman plus the sled, the mass of both of them, times g times the sine of 30 is a half. So we'll just go ahead and we can put that in now. Well, I'll tell you what, let's leave it here. Equal to negative MFS times acceleration in the x direction. So I'm bringing this thing over and then factoring out MFS. So the tension that John is exerting in scenario D will be equal to factoring out MFS. This term becomes positive when it comes over here, right? So we have g times the sine of 30 degrees minus, because this term got added to this negative term, and then we factored out that MFS, so minus the acceleration in the x direction, like so, right? So then we're going to come right here. And so the tension in part D will be equal to 45 for the mass of both of them added together, 9.81, sine of 30 is a half, so multiplying times a half. And this is open parentheses here, so we got to put this, let's do this. We'll do it like this. We'll just imply the multiplication with a little time sign right there. And then this will be times minus a half. So this will be minus 9.81 times a half minus the acceleration in the x direction. Well, we're told that he accelerates downward with 2 meters per second squared. So this is minus 2 right? Like so. And so 9.81 divided by 2 minus 2, and then all of that multiplied times 45, and we get the tension when Feynman is sliding to his peril. And for part D, that number will be 131 newtons. So this is at 131 newtons for part D, right? Okay, then for part E, now John is just completely, he just collapses and he just, the rope is just going freely, you know, away from him, right? And Feynman, and of course we can see right away that the tension is going to be zero, right? But let's do an analysis and see how the math will tell us. So Feynman is now accelerating at 4.905 meters per second squared, so that would be the given, right? And they'll say, due to this acceleration, what is his, you know, what's the tension exerted? So that could be a test question. It might not be 4.905, because I've carefully selected 4.905 so that Feynman is just sliding down freely. But it could be 3, right? It could be anything. So if you look at this equation right here, this equation is for Feynman sliding down the incline with some arbitrary acceleration x. All these other numbers are given. We know this is 45, we know this is 9.81, we know this is 1/2. This number is the thing that changes that, you know, on a test it could be, you know, 1.5, 1.75, it could be 3.2, whatever, and you'd be asked to find the tension that John is exerting to keep Feynman from sliding down. And so we can use this. So we say the tension in part E is equal to the mass of Feynman plus the sled times G times the sine of 30 degrees. So if you were to make note of this equation, you would, you know, this would be whatever the angle of the incline would be, right? This would be theta in general, if you were going to use this for any other problem. Minus, and then this will be the mass of the object that's sliding down, minus a sub x, like so, right? Plugging in numbers, this is 45, then we have 9.81 times 1/2 minus 4.905 is the acceleration in the final scenario. 4.905. And we didn't even have to draw the forces, right? We could have, you know, we could have done an analysis, but we're just making note that, you know, we're just realizing now what's going on and we're not having to do all this stuff, right? So this is the tension in part E, but just for your notes' sake. And then, okay, the acceleration in part E will be equal to negative 4.905, because it's negative 4.905 is describing it moving downward along the plane. So 4.905 x hat meters per second squared. So this will be the free body diagram for this last situation. If we carry this out, 9.81 divided by 2 is 4.905. You can look and just kind of see that, right? So then this is zero. The tension that John exerts at the end is zero, and Feynman slides down to his utmost peril. But hopefully he'll survive. Basset hounds are usually pretty resilient. Okay, so we have analyzed this problem fully. I'm going to step to the side and give you a clear screenshot. Internalize it, try it for yourself, and you'll be ready for the exam.